Oh, friggin' race, boys. Let's go have a look out into the yonder factor. She looks like the rains are coming. It's, what is it here? 10:16. Thursday, September 8th. They said they were gonna be here. Left my magnet outside. Like they're using my magnet. You know, my level, my stuff. I guess I'll bring my box of screws in. Holy. But yeah, they said they'll be back first thing in the morning to finish up the last few things. Finish up this and that. And yeah, but so it's like, you know, a nice and cool day. They could have come here a few hours, finished up before the rain comes, and then the roof would have been done and this and that. But no. Holy, downtown Inwood, bud. No. Oh man, I'm just choked. This is friggin' crazy. But they got three other jobs open today or something, he said. They got three other jobs open. So they gotta go waterproof them or something. I don't know. It's like, man, you start a job, you finish a job. Just drug all the sheets over here. So when the storm comes, like, man. Unreal, these guys. Just Deckard. Wow. He's gotta go get his special bender to finish bending those. Oh man. That's crazy. So it looks like about an hour. I still got an hour. You know what I mean? Well, 12 o'clock. I just showed up. First thing in the morning. Eh? Ridiculous. They're fucking rifling through the old bucket of screws to find good screws. What are you doing?
We're gonna be short a few screws. We already sorted through 90% of them. We're gonna magnet the ground real quick. I thought we looked a little bit short before we started though. There's one foam enclosure still left too. I'm gonna pay that bill for it when I go over there, so I don't have to go back there either. So it's minus $25, whatever that bill is.
Right on. Fucking putting old screws in the roof, man. This freaking cattywampus there. I sawed it. Freaking sawed it.
Okay, Costco, goof, you roof dick scene. You roof dick scene.
Son of a bitch. Oh, well, for friggin' my snack. Tip word saw on the hash. Terrible. Made us turn the wrong words. Friggin' driving around for aimlessly, relentlessly for half an hour. Just the wrong words. Terrible. Fuck a matter for yourself.
Big bird.
Big bird. Great on, but yeah, we got a freaking van load of freaking gym shit and a bunch of freaking grocery words for him. I forgot the shit that I needed to bring to the freaking machine shop dicks, just in a congratulation to being so freaking belligerent today, but way she girds. Maybe he just knows. They will be like, we got one of these things that needs those nuggets for the middle. That's not what he says. Oh, for fuck's sake, this is gonna be dicked. But any words, wishy girds, we'll go see Jim. Oh, son of a bitch. Oh, look, we made it onto the right road. What do you know about them apples? Well, you need to drop that off in Inwood, boss. Got a new milling machine.
Good lad.
But it's got Cat 40s onto it.
That's no problem.
You got them kind?
We got some. What are you looking for in
Cat 40s? How many Spensives?
It's bad, isn't it? Okay, what do you want to do? End mill?
Mill? I got the guys that hold the nuggets for the guy, you know what I mean? It's like a nugget inside, but I only got three different, well, I don't know if they're different because I only got two of the nuggets.
right? I got like a quarter inch nugget and then like a 3/8 nugget. No, it's maybe a half inch and a 3/8, but I need all the nuggets for all the different kinds. You know what I mean?
Well, okay, let me show you something. Okay.
But I also, I need the key with the one of them on board for undoing the nugget holder.
Gotcha. So you've got a collet hole by the sand.
Yeah, you
does
know.
It look like this?
See?
Does it look like that?
Yeah, that's the guy right there.
That's the guy. So it's a collet hole that's rolled in inwards.
Right there.
And those are the collets.
Yeah, the nuggets. You're not pronouncing it right.
Okay. Okay, so ER16, ER20, ER25, all across. So do you know what hole do you have?
See, I was going to bring them. Roof dicks cocked over my program. Got all disoriented.
Okay.
Couple hash tokes. Next thing you know, we're driving around on the other side of the 907. Not even driving here.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
I'm glad you arrived safe.
Oh, my goodness. Terrible.
Yeah. So I really can give you what you want, but...
You need the guy. Because there's three or four. Maybe I could just saunt them.
Well, you can look at the big... Going to throw you because some are so close.
Yeah. How many different kinds is there?
Well, the nuggets, a few nuggets.
Few different sized nuggets,
all these are ER collets.
No.
Yes, see. So you got sizes like this. You got sizes like this. You got sizes like this.
Yeah, see, it's more like this size, but it's... See, I have one that's a small and then one that's a little bit bigger. I got some nuggets that... You know, it's loose inside the guy. It's almost
wrong.
Like, because they're longer. They're about this long. You got those ones?
Hang
they're
on.
Longer?
Grab that phone.
Oh, you got to grab the phone. I apologize. I'm loud. He saw it. Oh, dick.
You talk longer, you're talking about a whole different thing again. You could be TG collets. See, I really do need your halt there.
Yeah, well, I'll have to bring them. I got all disoriented and I got these dicks up on my roof putting old screws in my new sheet metal and stuff, and I had to leave because I was going to go to prison. I was like, let's go to the machine shop, dicks, instead of prison. Hey, that's what I was like. Holy shit. Plus my son Jim, he's passing away.
He passed away.
Well, he's like 20 years old and he got an apartment, but he doesn't think, I need food and stuff. That's he didn't take an account for any of that stuff. So he's just in his apartment by himself, passing away.
Oh boy.
And then so we're like, hey Jim, how you doing? Oh, not so good, father. You know, do you think you could maybe bring me some sandwich? Like, holy fuck, Jim.
See, now this is what they call a type 25 and a type 32. They look very similar, but they're not.
Mm,
okay, and let me show you some more collets. These are TG collets.
You got one of those with round nugget?
Yeah, but I still need to know the size. See, all these are collets, and they're all slightly different.
Yeah, eh?
And I don't want to confuse the shit area. But you see where
you're
I'm going
with this?
You're
just fucking me over.
I am. Do you like it though?
You scoffing.
See, that's a roughing cutter.
Yeah. It's used. How much is this one?
Oh, that's not used.
What do you mean?
It's the plastic. No, but that's too big for your machine.
Too big for my machine?
Well, perhaps not. Perhaps not.
But that's got three horse in the downstairs and a two horse in the upstairs.
Yeah.
Right on. So I'll bring that. But do you got something like that in stock?
No. Because
you
I got some of it. You're so vague with it. I've got some. Okay, I need to know the arbor size of the face mount.
We need an antler about that big on the end of the
thing like that, which is a knob, right?
Yeah. The knob on the
okay, I need to know that hole size as a keyway cut in it. It's important. I know you don't think it is, but it really is.
You're going to end up having me bring like a whole toolbox full of shit here. Oh, yeah, look at that guy. How much is that?
Well, it's going to fit your machine.
Oh, it's just a little baby.
Well, this is a Cat 40.
Yeah, that's the taper.
That's right. ER, see the numbers?
Okay.
I need that kind of information.
Right on. Look at the little tiny one.
Well, because this is only
a 14. This is a little baby one.
But this is a 16 collet.
So I got the collet holders. So I just need the collets. How much is a set of collets?
For which one?
Give or take. No, they're the big ones. They're this big. They're not the tiny little ones. Like, give it ballpark. Are they $200? Are they $100? Okay, are they $60? Are they?
How many collets you want? So roughly $40 a collet on an ER40. That's right. And you won't need half of them. You really won't.
So you can't just buy like a set for $60 or something?
No. No. Sorry about that. Sorry.
But you can buy a whole set of R8 collets for $60.
Yes, a whole different thing. R8 collets are about $12.50 a piece. So yes, you can. See, you want to be a machinist?
No, I don't. I just turn fucking around, choo-choo on. You know what I mean? Make a spin 'em guy, choo-choo some chips. You know what I mean?
I hear you. But I mean, oh, why don't we do it right the first time? Just get you the numbers.
I'll just have to bring all my.
You don't have
stuff.
To read
bring
the
nuggets.
You got a cell can be... phone. Stand by your machine. Hold it in your hand. Call me. I'll write it down. Call you back and give you the information.
Right on. What's your card? I need your card because I keep forgetting. I don't even know what this place is called. I'm like the machine shop dick. I'm like, call the machine shop dick. He doesn't know what that is.
Yeah, I had some management.
Plus, I had a list of shit and I didn't even bring it.
Oh.
Oh, you got blue dichem spray.
Yeah.
Yeah, it really is crazy that we made it here. At all, it really is. Yeah, advanced tooling supplied. I'd have never guessed that. How much is this guy?
$5,000.
What?
Yeah, it's because it's general. I've drawn a wood for that.
Doesn't even have a handle on it.
Well, the handle's in the box.
I apologize. Oh, quick change cigarette butters. Hey, that's the thing too. I got ripped off. Hey, I bought those quick change tool posts, and my old ones, they don't fit on there.
Where'd you buy a quick change tool post from?
You!
The old ones don't fit on. You're losing me now.
I bought like the quick change tool post for lathe.
Yeah.
It's got 250 arse coals onto it. Plus, I only got two bit holders. I got one with a round thing into it, another one with the stupid slidey thing. I don't need any of that junk. You got any bit, like tool bit holders for the 250s? Since I got ripped off?
Is it a piston or is it a wedge?
It's a piston. But my old ones, right? They're actual Aloris, right?
Aloris is a whole different animal.
It doesn't fit.
Very expensive.
Yeah, they don't fit.
No. Well,
see, I got. You sent me one like this with a hole in it. What do I need this for?
That's for a taper shank drill.
Taper shank drill. So I put a drill bit into this,
and
I put that in. So then I have to make sure that I've centered this into the work, because you can't have it like off-cigarette or it's just going to munch. So I'm not going to ever use that. Why would you sell me this? I'm going to take that back and we're going to trade, okay?
You bring your shit in and show me what you got.
Yeah.
Here's what you're talking about.
But I need one with a big opening in it too. You're selling me ones with skinny openings.
Well, is there only certain size you can
get? I got to take it into the milling machine. Oh, yeah. See, I don't, you know what I mean?
You got one of those, right?
Yeah, I do got one of those, but I either need a cutter for that or throw it in the garbage.
Okay.
You sold me one of those too. What do I need that for? Were you even paying attention when I was asking you?
Yes, I was. Now that is for, again.
Oh, yeah. See, I got one of those too.
But you need them all, but if you don't use them, they're no good to you, right?
Yeah, but I got that. I need bit holders. So I can put like a 4.5 and a 9.0 and an L and a T on what, you know what I mean?
Do you ever think about shooting it?
What?
Okay.
Just poison slowly and smash potatoes.
With spit. Did you ever watch one of the movies?
Yeah, yes I did.
Or you did?
You got a guy that worships you and it's him who made me watch it. You think
See, I got one of those, eh? I got some of these tool holders, eh? But I don't have
horse.
I don't have the guy, you know what I mean? Yeah, that's what I should have done.
I think of those.
What?
Don't worry about those cheap ones in there.
Let's just get a couple of the 250 sizers, okay, and then I can just chooch them open. I can't make anything out your sand, boss.
I don't think I have any of the holders.
Oh, come on.
1050. No, I don't. But these are the ones I've got, and they're not holders, the part offs.
Yeah.
Tool post.
Oh, you quit the good ones?
We can get them for you one day. I'm going to give you a challenge. Stand by the side of the machine with a book and write down all the numbers for me, will you?
Homework.
And then I can solve it all for him.
Yeah, but I would have brought it. I had a list, but the roof dicks. Roof dicks says, oh, we'll be there first thing in the morning. Noon, they show up.
Oh.
But we are going to try to be out of here for like noon, 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
So then they just like put a big ripple in my cigarette. You know what I mean?
Oh, I hear you, man. Give me a break, will you?
Right on. Smoke cigarettes.
See you later. Have a good one. You have a rest till tomorrow.
Oh, dick. Looks like they got friggin' cigarette buttville blocked off. I think we sent on Facebook that there was a big crash up here or something. Oh yeah, big time. Oh yeah. Big time. That's not good. Holy. Big time crash. Wow. Holy. That's friggin' belligerent. Beard and safety. Beard and safety enthusiast. I'll tell him. I'm a beard and a safety enthusiast. How you doing?
Not bad.
Right on. Oh, maybe I should just start just smashing onto this guy. Brace up beside him and be belligerent with my one glove. Or my fingerless glove or something. But holy. They got her right for frogging a snack. Belligerent. None of that was even being recorded. Awesome. Jim, we're here to save your life, buddy. And none of it was being recorded, so we gotta do it all over again.
Right. Bring everything back down.
Oh, fuck. I was even trying to get bites of your buddy's fucking toast. Can I just have one? Just a couple. Oh, you already took bites off it. Disgusting. You already took bites off it, Jim. Oh, you love mummy sauce, buddy.
Yeah.
You love mummy sauce. Oh, Mr. Nudes! Mr. Nudes, bro! You love Mr. Nudes.
Some bread, some cakes, some types of the snacks.
Mr. Nudes!
I love chowdered clams.
Disgusting, Jim. What's wrong with your skull? Those things are like cracked open rocks with a tongue in it.
Yeah.
Disgusting.
Fuck yeah.
Gross.
Oh, the deep clean, that's from my... oil control, that's from my ball bag, that's from my dick.
Disgusting. All right, Jim.
See you, buddy.
Thank you.
Forgot to bring loads and loads of shit. I'm going to store some of my stuff here. All right? And bring a few loads of shit and we'll store it here. I ain't got room, eh? They made me get rid of my trailer. Oh, no, I could. There's lots of room in here. We could stack
well, yeah,
some stuff up.
Yeah,
no,
but I got to walk through here and shit.
Well, you can walk around it.
No.
What do you mean?
No. Yeah. You're like a fucking milling machine.
Well, no, I need to use that. We're going to be friggin', you know, all the crap that I took out of the shipping container and the trailer they made me get rid of and stuff.
We could store some piss mats in here.
Yeah, the piss mats. This would be a good place for the piss mats. They reek, eh? And the sun in the trailer. Oh, it reeks.
Build four.
Oh, it just reeks up your trailer?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. You can keep hearing.
Right on. You know, when Stinkbug's back, we'll get him to... because I don't want to touch them and shit. You and him can bring them up and...
sounds good.
Right on, man. Okay, see you later, Jim. Oh, nice meeting you.
See ya.
You two have some good relations.
Yeah.
smoke cigarettes. Fucking disgusting. Jim's new girlfriend's kind of ugly. He smells funny. It's fucked. It smells better than in here, though. Oh, yeah. There's where the terps are. Did you get a toke?
No, I held my breath.
I was decked. Couple piss mess right there had the collection. Freaking right. Classy freaking joint, man. Not dick. They're right behind us. Can you saunt them? He friggin' bussin'. Yeah, he friggin' did. Look at this friggin' thing. Oh, look. It's like a tire service repair rig. Sonic will give us a tunnel set. How you doing? Not too bad. You just opened?
Yes.
It's all fresh?
How many today?
Two.
Me okay. What have you found? A weird little fella. Fucking buddy just called. He's like, oh yeah, I need that money. I gotta get fucking this and that shit. It's like, bud. He must be on pills.
Hey, yeah,
can we get some more of these hot rags?
We'll give you a second one when you finish everything.
Oh.
I'll come here more often to change the napkin for you.
Please. Holy, I'm like sick. Is it delicious, terrible?
Mm.
Oh man, I'm starting to suck. It's like, yeah, a couple of screws, I missed the wood, so I had to put them on an angle. It's not a big deal, fucking. It just looks ugly.
Thank you.
Bonjour.
Oh,
my goodness.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
I bring the machine if you want to use seven credit cards, okay?
Yep.
All right, so feel free to want to leave any comments. Thank you.
Thank you. Comments. This will be good. I love to smoke hash. Something terrible. Others see you as lively. Friends see you as witty. Disgusting. Disgusting. I'll just take her up to the front. Somebody want this?
At the station.
Yeah, I quit that.
Huh?
We've been waiting and waiting.
Wait.
Do we run away?
Here you go. I can help you with the machinery.
You were running, eh? You thought we took off?
I saw you went to friend. We pay here.
Oh, I apologize.
Thank
you.
Thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you. You best be picking.
Welcome, man.
I would love something for picking.
Okay. Would you like to see you again soon?
Thank you.
How's your dinner?
Do you got something for picking?
Oh, okay.
Look, we got a dingley bobbler.
Yeah.
Put them on your nipples.
Yeah.
Do it like
that. Aw, dick. You bessin'. Got him right into the rhubarb, he did. Holy, what were you doing? What happened? Were you Spass Buchanan? You're probably Spass Buchanan. Son of a bitch.
The diddler wagon, terrible. Fuck you, Costco's, you son of a bitch, putting hair in your chicken, fucking pieces of shit.
I need some mirrors like that if anybody knows where to gaunt them.
You don't look like it.
How you doing?
Good, not how's
bad.
It going?
Not too bad. You work here?
Oh, yeah.
You got any hookups? You got any stash in the back or what?
Ooh, I can check. Give me a check.
Right on. Smoke cigarettes. What's really going on?
Scare me.
Why? Why are you always scared all the time? Look at the big hammer. Eh? It's a big friggin' hammer. Put it on. You see me on
YouTube.
On YouTube?
Yeah. You're from Inwood, right?
Yeah. Hey, is that your van?
Yeah.
Right on, man. That's hilarious. We've seen this van and we were like, oh, it's gonna make a, oh, this just happened, breaking news, just outside the diddler van. So we're back. Just do some investigations. Little bits of aluminum, broken up wood. This is the caulking that he used on my white roof. Black on my white roof. And then that's the leftover, that's the leftover roll of stuff. So then, I don't know if they did end up using any of the old screws, but they went and got a bag of new screws. There's straws and garbage, more garbage, more garbage, more garbage, more garbage. That looks like one of them new screws. There's more garbage. More garbage. More garbage. Huh? Big piece of friggin' dirty old, yeah, sheet metal just stabbed right into that wood there. That's Fred's wood. So this come off the roof and just friggin' plunged right into that. So that's pretty awesome. And then more friggin' washner, head washner guys. There are these washners off the screws. And these screws don't even have like a little metal arse cool, but there's some more. Oh, look at this one stabbed right in. Yeah, well, what's the deal with that? This one doesn't even have a metal washner onto it. Look at them all. Brand new friggin' screws. More washners. Oh, another screw. Like, wow, that must be nice, eh? That must be nice. Jump, there's another brand new friggin' screw. What is up with that? I just went and sprinkled the yard with new screws, I guess. There's some trimmings of the coil, yeah. Let's check out that edge. Ooh, yeah. That looks nice. That looks nice. You don't want to fold that over and make a safety edge and then fold a 90 into it or nothing. Ridiculous, man. Pick up your garbage. Deal with your horse shit. Fucking bullshit. But innards will go around the front. Oh, yeah. There's some more shit. I guess that's the rest of the foam enclosure. Eh? We'll just leave that in the bushes over here. Can you pay me? Eh? Where's my money? I'm gonna need that today. What's this? Oh yeah, gum wrappers and shit or whatever that is. More wrappers. Cigarette butts in the drain. Oh, there's a cigarette butt. There's a cigarette butt. Okay, there's a cigarette butt. I told him first thing, 100% important. My dogs get sick when they eat cigarette butts and they love that kind of terrible. So we have a cigarette butt bucket right there. And that's where we need you to put the cigarette butts. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, and blah, blah, blah. But just never even. Where's the garbage? Man, I heard that one more time. We were gonna have an issue. Let's see. Oh, they did. Oh, yeah. Right on, man. I really appreciate that. I really, really do. Just some garbage on the roof. Oh, yeah, some screws. I like that a lot. Washners. Oh, hey, can I pay you? Eh?
can I pay you? Wow. Like, just screws the whole length of the shit here. Wow. Just freaking crazy. Like, didn't even bother, like, you have a nail that's protruding above the chooch. That's, like, forced over. That's, like, completely pushed into the shit right there. There's a nail underneath the friggin'... Oh, man. Yeah, this guy can fuck right off. Oh, yeah, there you go. So that's how you... What? What? Dude. You're serious. You're serious right now. And you want me to pay you. Holy shit. Wow. Oh, man. How the fuck does this shit happen to me all the time? I didn't make up the price. I didn't ask him for a deal. There was none of that. It was like, oh, you do roofs? Yeah, I'm really thinking about, you know, doing the roof on the shop. Here's a friggin' nice screw on the roof for me, too. Oh, and there's a piece of metal, you know, if you're... That's not going to cut through this membrane or anything. Barely. It barely would. Probably. What the fuck is that? Screws and garbage and like the eaves troughs, even this. Where he's all mangled the shit out of the leaf guard there. Yeah, the eaves troughs are just full of stuff. The ridge cap, the panels, the sides of the roof don't even line up. Like, they don't even line up. Like, it's like, it's crazy. It's like 4 inches overhang. Like, they started opposite sides or something. Like, on the other side, they cut that overhang off, and it was all shitty dickered. So they decided not to do it on this end, I guess. Or, yeah, see, they got the sheet on crooked as fuck. That's what they did. By the time, you know, the backside isn't on straight, so it's like good down this end. I wouldn't say good, but it's better down this end. And then as you get, look at the foam enclosure, man. Like, they couldn't even be bothered to, you know, stick it in so it doesn't look like a complete goof did it. Well, and there's another nail. Where is it? Right there. Nails that are, you know, either didn't get pounded down or taken out. Before installations of the stovepipe, and then telling me, oh yeah, it's a little bit deckered because of the trim. He's trying to tell me that there's one side, I don't know which side it is, but one side, it's up higher, so it's not sealing properly. I think it's the side on the other side, you know, but there's nothing we can do. It's fine. It just looks like crap, that's all, and stuff. It's like, right on. As long as my brand new roof looks like crap, that's okay, right? No big deal. But anyways, oh man, I'm surprised this one isn't filled with screws. But I'll just finish cleaning up this mess and we'll have to figure out how much an hour I'm gonna pay myself, or they're gonna pay me, I guess, to do this, because I think we're going to court. I mean, I just, it's crazy, right? It's just really shittily done. That's great, you know. It's like if you had said, you know, well, I can do it for the price I'm telling you, really shitty, like we can do it really shitty, then I'd have been like, oh, okay, well, yeah, no, I don't want it done really shitty. I want it done good, right? So like, I'll pay a little bit extra, you know what I mean? Like, I'll pay more to have it done good rather than, you know, like whatever. If you want, there's another piece, like just pieces of metal and stuff from the roofing job just everywhere. Why? Right on. Yeah, we'll gather up
the nails.
Yeah, I've already grabbed a big pile of that crap, but yeah, like this caulking is, says doors, windows, and siding, nothing about roofs. I read all this, doesn't say anything about roofs at all. So, I don't know, man, that's pretty crazy, but wow, how the fuck does this shit happen? And then I told him when we were getting the originally talking to him about it, I says, yeah, I want to make sure we save all these sheets because, you know, I'm going to reuse them, make a fence out of them and stuff. Oh, yeah, no, I don't blame you, bro. That's still good materials and this and that and stuff and blah, blah, blah. But then starts firing him off the roof because he's all pissed off and belligerent. Yeah, so you're just dragging sheets across that still got nails in them. So it's like my whole yard's just going to be filled with nails. And I drive, you know, my trailers around in here, right? So, oh, man, these guys are fucked. Just crazy. Yeah, like I had to leave earlier because I was just starting to get so belligerent. So belligerent. I was just, you know, starting to saying and doing stuff I'm probably going to regret later. I don't like that kind too much. I try to want to keep her kosher and cordial, right? But sometimes you just got to lose your cool. So I'm terrible. But any words, we'll see what happens. I got Roof Dick Ron coming over tomorrow to just have a quick look, see, and this and that. But yeah, she's not looking good, boys. She's not looking good in the paying these fucking dicks department. And I feel bad too because, you know, it's not like they didn't work, right? They were up there sweating their sack off and they, you know, they were working. It's just their work's just shit. It's just no good, right? Like the whole backside is on there crooked. Like you can see down here. And as you get towards the top, it's not so cordial. What the fuck is that? Wow, man. That is good stuff right there. Holy. Oh my goodness. Half a Gatorade on my lawnmower seat. Thank you, but me okay. Oh, I just sicked out my butt. That was disgusting. That was a scuss. But any words, boys, we had fun at gyms and stuff, watching BMX videos and freaking Bizaminium, and then we were gonna take him out for the Mandarins, but it took like an hour to get from his house to the Mandarins, and then it would have been an hour to drop him back off, so we quit gym and we just went ourselves. Because we dropped Jim off all kind of foods anyway. He wanted to fuck foods. He's just make himself some foods now because he's just not perishing anymore because of the cordons of how awesome his father and his father's old lady are. Beg my pardon, but my videos are about 2 days. I like to keep them 2 days ahead in case something happens and I'm not able to, you know, record a video. I still got, you know, I got a day to catch up if I need to or whatever, right? This is in accordance to making sure that there's a Vitsy every day for you dicks to watch, but... So by the time you saw this, it's probably, you know, already, you know, whatever's happened has already started to happen because, you know, this dick still thinks that I'm going to pay him. But, you know, it's like with all the other experiences that I've had with drywall dicks and roofing dicks and different types of the dicks, it's like I want to see the finished product before the money is exchanged. I didn't make up the price. So as if, you know, if it was too cheap or too much or this or that, whatever. I agreed on the price you said. And that's, you know, what we're basing all of our shit on, right? Whether it's $50 or $50,000, that's irrelevant. If the guy told me, like, listen, man, I can do a really cobbled job for this price, but I can do a really, you know, like, it's going to be perfect for this much. You know what I mean? You pick. And then I would have been like, oh, well, I don't want it cobbled, right? So, it's, you know, if it cost me $500 more or something to get it done, you know, so that it's like a perfect, then, you know, that's cool, right? I don't have a problem paying a guy for his work. But that wasn't the case, and when the day that he finally did come, he said he was going to come Saturday. So I told him, I says, if, you know, make sure you're going to come because I don't want to order the stuff Friday if you're not coming till next week or something. You know, I'll just order it next week. You know, like I don't want the material sitting on the ground out in the middle of the woods for, you know, days and days and days, right? I just don't, right? That's potentiality for some dick to come by and put a big dent in the pile or whatever, you know what I mean? It's just, I just don't, right? So it's not even a big deal. That's, I just want to coordinate everything so that everything goes smooth. If you're coming Friday, we'll get it Friday. If we're coming Saturday, we'll get it Saturday. If we're coming next week, we'll get it next week. It's not a big deal, man. But he says, nope, Saturday, this and that. Saturday doesn't come. Sunday doesn't come. Monday, I can't remember what time right now, but, you know, finally comes. And he comes in, he's like, oh, I need to see that quote. You got that quote? So I'm like, yeah. You know, whatever. I grab him the quote, I show him, and he's like, yeah, see, I didn't charge you for this and that and the blah, blah, blah. So it's like this and that and, you know, whatever. But I'm like, bud? I'm like, bullshit. And, you know, yammered on a bunch more shit. And I'm like, I got everything you told me to get and this and that and blah, blah, blah. And he's, you know, blah, 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 mutters some stuff and then just goes and starts doing the roof. It's like he was, like, trying to nail me for more monies right off the bat. Like, I was getting nervous just getting the materials and having them dropped off, and then it sat here over the weekend. I'm like, man, this guy's not even going to show up, for freak's sakes. And they're in such a rush to get out of here and get paid that they can't even be bothered to pick up the screws and shit off my neighbor's property. Like, bud, this is just incredible. But yeah, we'll see what Randy the roof dick says tomorrow, and go from there. Like, I'm not a roofer. Maybe that's how you do it. Maybe when you do roofs, you make sure that it's so compa-wampus that your freaking ridge cap has like a big L bend onto it like that. Maybe I'm mistaken, because, you know, there's been times when I've been mistaken before. Right? So could possibly happen again. You son of a bitch. You roof dick same. Bother me. Some more brand new screws. There's a collection of cigarette butts, some older screws and washers. Water bottles in the grates and stuff. Perfect. Just splendid. See the say grip up in the grate?
There's one there, one there,
one there, one there, one there. Let's park his truck out here and just smoke in the say grates. But either way, my hourly rate for yard cleanup costs are just extravagantly inflated, terrible, so. Oh man, I think he's gonna probably owe me by the time she's said and done. They use my boots, they use my hard hats, they use my harnesses. For frick's sakes. Oh, yeah, and they're not even all in there. There's two harnesses. Yeah? Fucking. He took one of my harnesses. Here you go. There's a harness missing. Right on, man. That's top of the line unit right there. But they got decent. Well, that works out splendid. Oh, it seems like levels and harnesses. There's the this is the select choice of the friggin' thieving roofer dick, I suppose, there. Beg my pardon. And then he told me to make sure I get these rolls of crap to go under the metals. Need those. I don't do roofs if we're not doing them right and blah, blah, blah. So I got those two rolls. They're like $150 or something each. And then he starts pulling, oh, you don't even need those. I thought it was plywood underneath. Bud, you've got to be kidding me. Look at this building. You thought that it was plywood. Oh yeah, this is like brand new. Like 80 years ago when this was built, they didn't have plywood, bud. You know what I mean? It's clearly strapping. Even to this day, they friggin' strap steel buildings. Like, are you serious right now? For frick's sakes. But any words, boys. We'll daunt what saunts, and then we'll saunt what daunts. But any words, way she girds and inwood, I suppose. So there you go, another Dick and Pug One production. So until tomorrow.
Don't the roof dicks get you.